What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Hello and welcome. My name is Mitchell Saltzman, and this is Loop Hero. Now, Mitchell, you might ask, I keep seeing Loop Hero everywhere. It's on Twitch, it's on Twitter, it's in the news. Maybe not like the real news. There's more important stuff happening in the real news than Loop Hero. But, you know, it's selling a lot of copies, and you might know about that. And to the question of what is Loop Hero, I would have to reply, well, that's a tough question to answer, but let's do our best. So I'm going to jump into to my game. I am admittedly not very far in. I'm probably about maybe 3 hours or so. And a lot of that early going was figuring stuff out. So hopefully by watching this, maybe you'll get a little bit of a better idea of what's actually going on here. So Loop Hero is a strategy RPG roguelike, I think is the best way to say it. But not only is it random, like most roguelikes are, but the adventure aspect of it is also formed by your own decisions, both in the actual adventure itself and outside of it. So let's go over the outside part of it. This is our building menu. You can see there's a lot of stuff that I haven't made, a lot of stuff that I don't have the materials for, which we'll go into in a little bit. But basically what you want to do is you want to go into an adventure with the idea of bringing back as many resources as you can. I'll go into how you get resources once we actually get into the adventure, but there are three results that you can get in an adventure. You can beat the boss and get 100% of the resources that you gained in that adventure, and bring them back to be able to build these structures right here. You could get to your starting base in the loop and retreat, which gets you 60% of what you collected, and then if you die, you get 30% of what you collected. So you take those resources and you bring them back here. Some of the stuff that I haven't made yet that would help out: I can make a refuge, and that would unlock a new class for me. I could get a gymnasium and unlock the village card. We'll get into the deck building aspect a little bit. Like I said, it's a very hard question to answer. What is Loop Hero? But yeah, so we'll get into that in a bit. I can make a farm, which I actually already have. And I can't make a smelter yet because I need to first make a smithy. So this is, again, a very large tree of structures that you can make. Let's talk about the deck, though. So if we go back to Expedition, this is the deck that I have. So every time you go into an adventure of Loop Hero, you bring in a deck. I can only have a maximum of 12 cards. And this is one of the things that I think is very hard to wrap your head around in Loop Hero. Because what you're actually doing, you're bringing cards that sound like they would be a disadvantage to you. You're basically making spawn points for tougher enemies that will spawn in the levels. So this will spawn spiders, this will spawn vampires. This not only spawns a chest, which is good, but it also makes it so that enemies that are on adjacent tiles to the battlefield can become ghosts, which makes it so that you kill them and then they come back as a harder enemy. So it's not great. And then you have something like the swamp, which spawns a mosquito, but also healing effects here hurt you. So that actually has some interesting synergy, which I'll talk about later. We're gonna be using the swamp, but yeah. So this is basically what you're taking in. Every card that you get from the build aspect comes in here. You can choose what you want to take in, what you don't want to take in. I kind of want to have a grove. So what do I want to remove so I can have a blood grove? I'm gonna take out, you know, I don't really know how to use chrono crystals all that well. I'm gonna take that out and bring in blood grove. And I'm sure there are people who are very experienced in this game screaming at me, why would you take off chrono crystals? But you know what? If you don't know how to use them, then, you know, they don't do you much good. All right, so I think we're ready to jump into it. All right, so here we go. As you can see, as the name implies, Loop Hero is all about a hero who fights on a loop. Let's just pause right here. This is the Cozy Camp. This is the starting point. And basically, it's go in Monopoly. When you pass go, you get 30% of your health back. These little enemies that appear right here are enemies. And basically, they are mostly your source of gearing up. Because every time you pass go, not only do you collect $200 and 30% of your health, but you also increase the enemy level of the world. Excuse me. So what we're going to have to do, because the enemy level is going to keep going up, we're going to have to get stronger. And the only way to get stronger, really, is by fighting stronger enemies. So we're going to get some cards that are going to let us spawn stronger enemies like spiders, vampires, mosquitoes, etc., etc. And let's just show you all what that looks like. So right now we got a swamp. The swamp is interesting because... the swamp is interesting because it's kind of a tricky card to use. It spawns a mosquito every 3 days, which is not that bad. But what is very bad about it is that it also causes your healing effects to be lethal. So if you have something like vampirism, which causes you to deal damage and then gain life back, basically you're going to be hurting yourself every time you deal damage. But the important distinction to make, or the important thing to note, is that if you have vampires that spawn there also, the same thing holds true for them. All right, we got a battlefield. I'm going to put the battlefield right here. Come on. Is this better? No, it's not. All right, let's pause for a sec and start putting down some mountains. The mountains will give you, what do they do? 2 HP and then 2 more HP for every adjacent rock on a mountain. So what you want to do is kind of make a 3x3 grid to maximize the amount of health that you get from the rocks, but also it'll transform into a special mountain which will also spawn tougher enemies that will help you out. Or, you know, hinder you. That's the whole thing of Loop Hero. We're gonna be risky here. We're gonna try to put a vampire mansion right next to a swamp. What this will do is this will put a tough enemy onto the swamp, but also what it'll do is it will make it so that tough enemy will deal damage to themselves every time they hit, just like we would if we had vampirism. The challenge that there is gonna arise from that is that vampirism is a really good way to sustain yourself over the course of an adventure. So you have to be aware if you have vampirism and be able to take it off if you need to. All right, let's put a grove. Put it right here, sure. Every time you pass a grove, you get some resources, and they also spawn some tougher enemies. Spider. I don't want to put these guys too close together because it can be bad news if they overwhelm you. Okay, another vampire mansion. For this one, do we want to put it right next to a swamp also? Should we just put all of our vampire mansions next to a swamp? Let's try it. Let's see what happens. It's probably a disastrous idea, but you just gotta be aware that that's Boardwalk and Park Place. Don't want to land there, and in certain situations, I'm just comparing Loop Hero to Monopoly at this point. Okay, we're fine. We can put a Blood Grove right here. That will make it so that focusing right now. The Blood Grove will make it so that when enemies spawn on a grove, when they get 15%, when they only have 15% of their life left, God, I can speak, it's fine. Whenever they have only 15% of their life left, the grove will basically eat them, and it'll be a quicker way of dealing with certain enemies. Okay, so we get Vampirism here. Let's get that. We're gonna use Vampirism for now. To try and keep us sustained. And then we just gotta remember that when we get around here, we gotta hope that we have a new ring to use. One of the things that I'm doing, every time I put a meadow down, I'm trying to put it next to a rock or a mountain, because if you do, you'll get 3 HP at the start of each day instead of just 2. Okay, put another spider right there. Ooh, good. Level 3 sword. I'll take that. Damage is so important. Oh, I don't have a buckler. Another rock, another meadow. Let's see. Sure. Go for the defense there. Another battlefield. Having 2 of these will create a bloody path that spawns a blood clot. Which hopefully will be fine. Again, we have to hit a balance of spawning tough enemies, but also being able to deal with those tough enemies. So, I'm hoping I don't overreach here. Okay, so we're coming to the swamp. We're gonna have to fight a vampire. So, I'm gonna have to say goodbye to this ring. Because it's gonna hurt a lot. It's just fine. I don't think that ring was that good. Okay, this gives me 11 defense. I'll take that. So because we got 10 mountains spawned, that spawned a goblin camp, which is right here. Ooh, here we go. Actually, that's not that great. Is the attack speed worth it? Yeah, I think it's worth it. It's not that much of a difference in damage. Come on. Come on. I want to put the rock down. 2 damage to all is not worth giving up that defense. And pause. Alright, let's calm down for a sec. Put some rocks down. Another mountain. Another meadow. What I should also be doing is I should be anticipating that I get a treasury, and what a treasury will do is if I put a bunch of... Actually, no, I can't do that, because the treasury you can't put if it's next to... Never mind, I'm just talking to myself at this point. should we oblivion these? Let's do it. That's a lot of scariness to deal with right now. Alright, cool, we got a treasury. Sure, we'll put that on. Another mountain. Oh, whoops. Should have done the treasury first. So the treasury, when you put stuff around it, it'll get an extra bit of resources. And your goal is to completely surround it, to basically break open the treasury and get a whole bunch of resources from that. Okay. Whoop, should have put that right there. It's okay. Another beacon. I don't know if I ever explained the beacon. The beacon will increase my attack speed, or movement speed and attack speed when I'm in range of it. So let's put it right... I'm gonna put it right here because these are gonna spawn tough enemies, and also because it's near a battlefield, those enemies can become ghosts, which basically makes it so that I have to fight them twice, or I have to do a fight twice. Okay, another treasury. Let me put that right there. Another swamp right here. And then another beacon. So we have something to deal with the vampires. Nothing else interesting here. A blood grove. Put a blood grove right here. Alright, I think we're good. We don't have any vampirism, right? Just checking. I don't remember if I ever mentioned it, but you should be able to gather by now. I'm not actually doing anything during these battles. They're completely auto-played. All you really have to worry about is the decisions of what you're putting on your gear and what you're doing with your cards. Alright, so now we have vampirism with that. Alright, once we get through the swamp... Actually, there's no enemies on the swamp, so we're fine. Let's equip that. More vampirism. Okay, so... Just, we gotta remember, when we come back around, we're gonna have to change out our weapon and our ring. But this should be fine for now. Alright, look at all this. Alright, cool. That's good, that's good. I'm not gonna change that out right now. New cemetery. So you can see, I'm getting all these materials for all the weapons that are not, that are basically being pushed out of my inventory. Okay, let's get that going. Do we want another grove? Sure, we'll put another grove right there. And... I'm gonna hold off on the rest of this stuff. I'm not feeling super strong right now. What else we got here? This will be good to switch once we get closer to the swamp, but right now I think I kind of want to keep my vampirism going. Do I? That's a lot of damage though. See, these are the kinds of tough decisions you have to make. It's too much damage. I gotta swap it out. This is 5 damage to all. No, I don't think that's worth swapping out just yet. Come on, come on, come on. Ooh, man, that bloody meadow's doing work. Or bloody grove, rather. standard battlefield. Put that right there. Another grove. I need another bloody grove. 10% vampirism on that. Nah. Alright, things are not looking great. But I think we can still salvage. At the very least, if we're not going to beat the boss, then we should be able to get a good amount of materials to go back. Which is what it's all about. Okay, this is something that we can just put on right now. So we still have 6% vampirism on that. This is what we're going to swap once we get close to the swamp. Let's put that on. Alright, I think we're good. Man, I get so many swamps. Come on, buddy. Pull through. Pull through. There you go. The music in this game, though. So good. Alright, we're not doing too bad. I think we're doing okay here. Put another meadow right here. We got another beacon. Let's put the beacon close to the start. Just in case we want to fight the boss, which I doubt we're gonna be able to do. Anything else here? Just look for those arrows going up. Yeah, I think that's worth. Another meadow. Anything else? Anything else? Okay, I think we're good. Ooh. Not great. Okay, we're coming to the swamps, so what did I say? What did I want to switch it with? It was this one? Yeah. So now we can check. We don't have any vampirism. Looks good. Oh my god, these god dang mosquitoes! Magic damage 9 is pretty good. Is it worth losing 7 defense? Man. Tough decisions. You know what? I kinda wanna do it. That's good. I'll take that. Okay. Another blood grove. Put it right there. What else? More groves. Do we want to use them? I think, honestly, I'm fine with how the enemies look right now. I think we're at a good spot where we can kind of deal with what is on the field right now, and I don't want to push it. But I do want to use an Oblivion, because this is probably going to get knocked off if we don't use it. Let's get rid of these spiders. Okay. Weapon. Oh, I need a better weapon. No, it's not worth it. I need the damage. I would really like something that's not a great weapon. Okay, well, I'll take that. 20% attack speed. Is it better than those things? You know what? I'll take it. Another battlefield. Put it right about here. This is gonna be a nasty fight. Oh man, we got two nasty fights coming up. Just make sure. Look for that up arrow. Look for that up arrow. Man, that bloody, what is it? The blade thing doing work again. Alright, here we go. Let's look at what we got here. That's good. We got Vampirism there. Do I have a Oblivion? No, I don't. I'm gonna hold on to this ring. We'll put it on after we get past the swamps. Oh man, I'm beginning to wonder if it's worth putting the swamps there. I'm starting to think it's not. Like, yeah, it does make the vampires a little easier to deal with, but alright, let's put this right there. Another treasury. Should have put that down first. Because we could have 15% vampirism right now. Alright, we'll deal with it. What are we on? We're on level 6. I really want an Oblivion so I can nuke those swamps. Oh, level 8. Okay. I'll take that. Seems worth it. Level 7. Ooh, 15 magic damage. I'll take that. That's equal. Okay. Another rock. All What do we have here? You know what? The difference is small enough where I can justify putting that on. And then, oh, we got this. Yeah. Let's do it. Okay, now before we do... No, we're still not on the swamp yet. Oh my god, hit him! Come on! Another beacon. Sure, we can put that right there. Another rock. Now, do we want to use this instead of this? I don't think so, honestly. 15 magic damage is a lot. I think we're fine. Oh, but you know what? Here's the thing. It's a lot, but 15% vampirism for this would be pretty big. I'm gonna give it a shot. If it's a mistake, then we'll live with it. But I would really like to see if we can get some life back here. And you know what? That's kind of what Loop Hero is all about, right? It's about learning from every loop. And if you don't make mistakes, you can't learn. Oh, this has 16% vampirism. Let's use that. Ah, it's a mimic! Percent vampirism plus and magic damage. Okay, yeah, we're doing that. Oh god, I want to live. If we can get to the end, we gotta run. Okay, another mountain, and we got an oblivion. Okay, our goal right now is to get to the go and not die. Oh god. Okay. Okay, we can do this. Where are we gonna have to oblivion? Yeah, I know, it's very scary. Okay, I think we can deal with spiders. Let's hold on to it until we get to this goblin camp. I think those goblins are gonna give us trouble. Damage all evasion. Do we wanna use this? No, I think I'm fine with the other thing. Okay. Come on, let me survive. Rock. Oh no. Oh, one other thing that we can do. Oh wait, no, hold on, time out. Oh, come on, time out. I'm out! Pause. Okay. So if we hold down... Oh, wait, no! I hit the wrong button! Time out! Once again! Okay. If we hold down the button on the retreat thing, we can make it so that it will auto ask me once I get to the end if I want to return... if I want to retreat. Okay. Focus. Okay. What do we want here? We got a bunch of stuff. Okay, mountains. Let's do mountains. Put a meadow. Right there. More rocks, more mountains. Okay. I don't think there's anything on my loot that I want. We can oblivion. Let's oblivion this. Okay. What do we get? Nothing really all that interesting. Oh man, we just gotta survive these two fights and then we're good. Come on, pull through! Come on, no! Come on! Yes! Pause! Can we just retreat right now? I think we gotta retreat here. Yeah. Let's see what happens. Okay. It just retreats. I know that was anticlimactic. I wish we were able to get to the boss and at least see what he was like, but I wouldn't have survived that next fight, unfortunately. And that's how Loop Hero is. But we got a good amount of materials. Let's just see what we can do here. We can build a refugee. We can build a refuge. Build another farm, gymnasium. This gets the village card, which I think is pretty good. Unlocks the ability to gain special traits after killing monsters and expeditions. Yeah, let's do that. Let's put it right here. There's no ill intent. Without education, our world would be left to the savages. You too can learn a few things, though. We could all get together and share our useful knowledge and skills. I can't speak. Now I already know all I need to. Leave learning to the kids. Your first lesson, learn to like learning. That would make life easier for both of us. All right. And I think that's all we can do. So yeah, guys, that is a quick rundown of Loop Hero. Hopefully you got a better understanding of what it actually is, what it looks like to be played, how it can be extremely stressful, especially towards the end there. And it's really a game about making really, really tough strategic decisions. And in that way, it's very satisfying. So yeah, that's all from me. Once again, I'm Mitchell Saltzman. You follow me on Twitter @JurassicRabbit. And for everything else, keep it here on IGN.